They're selling postcards of the hanging. They're painting the passports brown. The beauty parlor's filled with sailors. The circus is in town. Here comes the blind commissioner. They've got him in a trance. One hand is tied to the tightrope walker. The other is in his pants. And the riot squad, they're restless. They need somewhere to go. As Lady and I look out tonight from Desolation Row. Cinderella, she seems so easy. It takes one to know one. She smiles, puts her hands in her back pockets, Betty Davis style. And in comes Romeo, he's moaning. You belong to me, I believe. And someone turns and says to him, my friend, you better leave. And the only sound that's left after the ambulances go is Cinderella sweeping up on Desolation Row. Now the moon is almost hidden. The stars are beginning to hide. The fortune-telling lady has even taken all her things inside. All except for Cain and Abel and the hunchback of Notre Dame. Everybody else is making love or else expecting rain. And the good Samaritan, he's dressing. He's getting ready for the show. He's going to the carnival tonight on Desolation Row. Ophelia, she's neath the window. For her I feel so afraid. On her 22nd birthday, she already is an old maid. Now to her death is quite romantic. She wears an iron vest. Her profession is her religion. Her sin is her lifelessness. And though her eyes are fixed upon Noah's great rainbow, she spends her time peeking into Desolation Row. Einstein disguised as Robin Hood with his memories in a trunk passed this way an hour ago with his friend, a jealous monk. Now he looked so immaculate as he bummed a cigarette. Then he went off sniffing drain pipes and reciting the alphabet. You would not think to look at him, but he was famous long ago for playing the electric violin on Desolation Row. And Dr. Filth, he keeps his world inside of a leather cup, and all his sexless patients, they are trying to blow it up. Now his nurse, some local loser, she's in charge of the cyanide hole. She also keeps the cards that read, "Have mercy on his soul." They all play on the penny whistle. You can hear them blow if you lean your head out far enough from Desolation Row. Across the street they've nailed the curtains, they're getting ready for the feast. A phantom of the opera in the perfect image of a priest. He is spoon-feeding Casanova boiled guts of birds. He will kill him with self-confidence after poisoning him with words. And the phantom is shouting to skinny girls, "Get out of here if you don't know. Casanova is just being punished for going to Desolation Row." Now at midnight, all the agents and the superhuman crew come out and round up everyone that knows more than they do. Then they take them to the factory and the heart attack machine is strapped across their shoulders. And then the kerosene is brought down from the castles by insurance men who go check to see that no one is escaping to Desolation Row. Now praise be to Nero's Neptune, the Titanic sails at dawn. Everybody is shouting, "Which side are you on?" And Ezra Pound and T.S. Eliot, they're fighting in the captain's tower, while calypso singers laugh at them and fishermen hold flowers. Between the windows of the sea, where lovely mermaids flow, and nobody has to think too much about Desolation Row. Yesterday, about the time the door knob broke, when you asked asked me how I was doing. Was that some kind of joke? All these people that you mention, yes, I know them, they're quite lame. I had to rearrange their faces and give them all another name. Right now my head